Okay, the radio station, 深夜放送, so like night broadcast. In the middle of the night, 深夜, deep in the night.
Masaki が死んだ。
あ、Masaki が死んだ。
ある日朝起きたらそんな連絡が入っていた。
あ、
バカな。そんな、だってこの前会ったばかりだ。
うん。
ラジオの仕事が軌道に乗ってきたって嬉しそうに話していたあいつが死んだ。俺は信じられなかった。
信じられなかった。
いつものようにラジオを流した後、ラジオ局で亡くなっていたらしい。
ああ。
原因は不明だと。
おお、原因は不明だと。
不明？どういうことだ？おそらく自殺だろうということで、警察は早々に捜査を打ち切った。
What a nice voice.
自殺。
自殺。
ふざけている。あの夜、あの放送で何かがあったのは間違いないはずだ。
ん？
俺は自分で弟に何があったのか調べること
にした。Oh, your little brother. Oh, lots of questions.I need to. That is way too much sensitivity. Car key.
Oh.
A letter. The key to the radio station in the mountains is in the mailbox at home. You may take it if you need it. Hashimoto. Key to the radio station in the mountains is in the mailbox. Okay. Ooh, big flashlight.I love how it's like at the bottom of the screen. It always makes me feel like they're holding it like this. I am investigating. Man, this is one empty house. Can't see anything here. I think I just gotta go.
Oh.
God, it's so dark. And I just upped the brightness.
Oh.
What house number am I?It's unclear. Oh. I'm hearing something. Like a dog? Howling? Get on car. Is that a map? Is that a map in the car? Oh, maybe I need to...How do I select it? Ah. Oh, that's loud. Holy shit. Oh God, am I driving it? Oh. Oh, oh, can't go that way. Ah.Oh my god. Oh my god. Oh no! Why am I driving? Oh god! Okay, there's a tunnel here. God, this is so loud. Wait, how do I... Oop.How did I get into my menu? Oh, there. Okay, that's a little bit better. That's me in the car. What is this? Oh, this is the radio station.Is that okay or is it now too soft? How do I turn on the flashlight? Oh, it is on. Oh, hello. It's a coin. 10 yen. Should I use it? I need the station key. It was in the mailbox, wasn't it? My little car, my little K truck. No, God, it's so hard to see anything. I don't know why a mailbox would be behind the house, but ooh, there's something here. I saw it. Hello? I don't know about you guys, but I don't see a mailbox. I don't see anything, actually. It's so fucking dark. Oh, I have no idea how I got here. Wait, what's behind the... And now we're going further. Well, might as well actually have a ride around town. This is surprisingly accurate. Like, I used to live in the middle of nowhere with, like, little... Well, the streets are actually more narrow than this. This is a very generous street. Oh, can I go through this? Oh. But it's, like, just a house here and there. Oh, God. Oh, God. Okay. Maybe that yellow circle is the house that I'm getting to. Oops. God, this car transforms into a demon when you back it up. I'll show you back enough! And then the car's just like, ah! Okay. Let's go to that circled house. What's this? Trash area. Cargo. Brr. What is that? I think it's illegal to dump garbage here if you're not allowed to, if you don't have permission. Oh, this camera, security camera is in place. Padlock. Yeah, garbage place. Collection days, Fridays. Okay. You can leave garbage up until 8 a.m. before on Friday, and then they come pick it up. Just so you guys know. I can read Japanese, it's whatever. Let's go to the house. I'm going the wrong way! Ah! Back it up, sir. Unleash the beast! Okay. Yes. So it should be right around this curve. Or, yeah, curve in the road. I think it's here. Enter. Is this the mailbox? Station key. Yes. Where'd my light go? Oh, because I'm holding the key. Can I go in? No. I keep thinking this is a fucking person. Hello. I'm being Snoopy. I am snooping. Small little house. It's still really dark, don't you think? Oh well. Leave. We have the station key. Rap-a-bum! Woohoo! Let's go! I'm driving on the right side of the road, even though I should be on the left. Oh, it's a general store here. I kinda wanna check the other locations too. Like that thing that's up top, down the road to the right, and then there's a vending machine down the road. Maybe we can put that coin there? Maybe we should check there first. So here. Getting good at this. Oh, yeah. This is a vending area. I'm scary when I drive. I sure am. I used to drive all the time in Japan. Anything? Public phone. DVD, video, guzu, hon. This is like a... Oh god, what was it called again? Book off. Yeah, I think it's called book off. It's like a recycle store, mostly dealing in books. Oh, ice cream. I miss Japanese ice cream. Oh. So good. What's this? UV flashlight. Oh no. We're gonna see some nasty shit. Well, I got a flashlight, but I don't know what I do with that. Does Sean drive? No, he doesn't. Okay, we're heading back. This way, and then here. Oh my god. Fight, little truck, fight! You have the horsepower to climb! There you go. What is at the end here? A warehouse. How long was I in Japan? Last time, almost 5 years. Oh, I don't have my- oh, yes, I do. I was gonna say, I don't have my regular flashlight anymore. Not that it helps. The cicadas. The sure sounds of summer. Oh. Hello? Wait, what? What the fuck? This doesn't open either. Weird. Must be something for later. Did something just walk by the car? I was just like scratching my eyebrows, so I don't know if I saw that correctly. Yeah, funny thing is, this little K truck. K means light, so it's like a light truck because it's so tiny. Take a left and then a right. Little K trucks like these in the countryside, you always have to be careful because it's always like old farmer people who ride these little trucks. Oh, I need to take this and stop. And like, they drive so fast, and they don't care. So whenever I see them on the road, I'm always like, oh, what are you gonna do? I'm gonna keep my distance. Okay. Just around here. Oh. This it? Yeah. Enter. Skirt, skirt. Light. Let there be light. Tape recorder. Okay. Is that a tape? The fuck? Okay.
はい、鬼川まさきです。このコーナーでは僕、まさきがリスナーさんから送られてきたホラーな話を読んでいきます。ということで、早速読んでいきたいと思います。ラジオネーム、とうこさんからの手紙です。これは、霊感のある同級生の小学生の時の話です。その子は生まれつき霊感がありました。保育園の頃ははっきり見えるわけではなく、なんとなくもやのようなものが見えたり、一定の場所がひんやりと感じたりする程度だったようですが、小学生になってからははっきり見えるようになったそうです。いつも同じ場所に男の人がただ立っているなと思っていたら、他の人には見えていないことを知ったことが始まりだそうです。そこから見えるという恐ろしさを感じるようになっていったといいます。女の人が彼氏とカフェでお茶をしているなと思ったら、彼氏の方の足がなかったり、可愛い女の子が公園で遊んでいるなと思ったら透けていたりと。幸いにもその子は声が聞こえることはなかったこともあってか、実害がなかったので気にしないようにするようになりました。小学5年生くらいになった時でしょうか、一人の幽霊が自分の後をついてくるようになったのは、いつも何かを言っているようですが、何を言っているのかわからないので鬱陶しいと思っていたそうです。そんなある日、一つの事件が起こりました。その日は友達と遊んでいて、知らないうちに暗くなってしまっていて、急いで一人で帰っていたそうです。薄暗いからか、少しの物音でも反応してしまい、怖くなってしまっていました。そんな時、こんばんは、と声をかけられたそうです。振り返ると中年のおじさん、一人家まで送ってあげようか。そう話すおじさんに、恐怖を覚え断って去ろうとすると、腕をつかまれ、送ってあげると言ってるじゃないか、と。恐怖のあまり声も出ず固まっていると、急におじさんが悲鳴を上げて逃げていったそうです。おじさんが見ていた方向を見ると、そこにはいつもの幽霊が。幽霊はその子を見守ってくれていたのでしょうか。
うん。7-1。 Oh, my brother's voice. Said there are 6 more tapes. I have to find them all. Yeah, that would be cool. That was a great tape to listen to.Rotten food. Nothing else, it seems. Where are we gonna find those tapes, though? Keep thinking there's someone gonna be around the windows.Okay, let's go in here again, because I didn't really explore here. Almost choked a mouse pit. It's too exciting! Okay, well, I'm not really seeing anything. Plus, the tape was really well lit, and it has like a question mark icon, so I feel like we would see it if it was on the ground or something.Don't you think? Oh my god, all these drinks! Oh my god. Instead of karupisu, it's kurupisu. Some green tea. Pepsi. Pipishi. Oh, vitamin CC lemon in Japan. I used to drink that a lot. This is orange juice. Pocari sweat is called mokari. I like that. Oh, it's chief. Suntory chief. What always amazed me in Japan is that this like little slot here, like Japanese vending machines, you can just put a 1,000 yen bill in it, into it, like a paper bill. I don't know about you guys, but in the Netherlands, it was always just coins. So if you didn't have coins, you either had to like get it exchanged into coins somewhere, or you just couldn't get your stuff. But here you can just put 10 bucks in, basically. So I have rotten food, a UV light, and a 10 yen coin. Cape Town is both coin and note. I feel like nowadays everything is probably just contactless. I wonder where we should go. Maybe to the garbage place with the rotten food? I feel like there might be a cat or a dog we can give the food to, but it's rotten though, so I don't know. I wouldn't want to kill them. Oh, hey, a car crashed. Uh-oh, I got another tape! Is anyone in the car? I don't see anyone. Oh, but there was also a padlock here. I don't have a key to, do I? I don't see any marks anywhere. Oh, that's the reflection. Weird, those little dots. Well, I guess we have another tape now. I guess I'll go back. I really like this now. I didn't expect to be driving around, and at first it felt very wonky, so I was like, oh no. But I really enjoy it now. Nah, they kind of got the hang of it. And the fact that you can't really trash your car is really nice. Whoa, did my engine just die? Oh. Yeah, I think my engine died. What do I do? I'm just coasting. What's happening? There's something there, but it's so dark that I couldn't see. And you're just driving? Shouldn't you check your back seat again? Oh, I hadn't seen that little house yet. On the right. There's a little house here, hidden in the darkness. There's someone there! Hello, excuse me. Wait, where did he go? The fuck? He was just here. I definitely saw someone. What? How the fuck? What is he looking at? Something in between the monitors? I don't see anything. On the lower monitor? Oh! Break it. Oh, well spotted, you guys. Holy shit. Do you think that's my brother? He was definitely pointing us towards one of the tapes. Don't trust it. Lock the door.
Masaki のホラーの話。
Oh, it's midnight. Oh, fuck. I'm doomed.
はい。今回もやってきました。ホラーの話。今回も手紙読んでいきますよ。ラジオネーム、トウコさんからの手紙です。お、この人前も送ってくれた人ですね。前回の話、とっても良かったので、今回も楽しみですね。これは、いとこが確か中学生の時、いとこは家族が病気になり、とても気を落としていたそうです。いとこはその時のことを人生で一番どん底だったと今でも言います。
どん底。
家族が病気になったけど何もできず、苛立ちと不安で情緒不安定になり、不登校になったと言います。何もする気になれず、ただ空を眺めてはため息をつく。そんな毎日を過ごしていたそうです。しかし、そんな彼女に唯一一つの希望がありました。親友の存在です。小学生の時に意気投合した友達がおり、とても仲が良かったそうです。その子はいとこのことを心配して、毎日家に来てはいとこの苛立ちや不安に寄り添って話を聞いてあげたり、学校での楽しい出来事を話して笑わせてあげたりと、暗い心を照らしてくれたそうです。いとこの家に親友が泊まっていくこともあったそうです。そんなある日、今日も親友が来てくれるのを楽しみにしていたいとこがふと時計を見ると、いつも来る時間より30分も遅れていることに気がつきます。部活が長引いているのかもしれない。今日は忙しくて来れない日なのかもしれない。そう自分に言い聞かせていましたが、チクタクチクタクと時計の音は大きくなるばかりです。遠くからピーポーピーポーと救急車の音が聞こえる気がします。と、プルルと一本の電話がかかってきたそうです。親友が交通事故に遭ったと。親友はそのまま帰らぬ人になってしまったそうです。いとこは自分を責め、生きる意味をなくし、たどり着いた先は自殺でした。誘われるかのように橋から身を投げ出そうとした時、いとこを呼ぶ声が聞こえました。構わず飛び降りようとすると、また呼ぶ声が。今度はそれだけではなく、女の子の顔が目の前に現れたそうです。それはあの親友の顔だったそうです。いとこは驚きと戸惑いとが一気に溢れて、親友を思い出し、その場で泣き崩れ、自殺はやめたようです。それから親友の声も顔も聞くことも見ることもできず、その時一瞬だけだったそうですが、いとこにとって親友はこれまでもこれからもかけがえのない存在だそうです。
なんなのに？
なんなのに？ OK。Next one. What was that sound? Something dropped somewhere.
Masaki のホラーの話。はい、始まりました、ホラーな話。今回はどんな話が出てくるのか、手紙を読んでいきましょう。ラジオネーム、トウコさん。またまたこの方ですね。まあ、このトウコさんが送ってくれる話は幽霊のほんわか話なので、今回も楽しみですね。今回はどんな幽霊が出てきてくれるのでしょうか。これは友人が高校生だった時の話だと言います。家族が病院に入院することになり、毎日病院にお見舞いに行っていたそうです。その病院は総合病院だったのもあり、大きくて医者や看護師の数も多く、いつも人が出入りしているような病院だったようです。ちょうどその時期は人事の時期だったのか、 見たことのある看護師を見なくなったり、新しい看護師をよく見るようになったりと、人の入れ替わりが多かったように感じていたそうです。いつものように家族のお見舞いに病院へ行った彼女は、今日もまた廊下で新しい看護師とすれ違います。その看護師は家族がいる部屋の方から来たので、何気なく家族に、また新しい看護師入ったの?と尋ねると、いや、知らないよ。と言われました。自分の勘違いだったのだろうか。前からいた看護師なのか、違う部屋から来た看護師なのか。記憶をたどり、出てきた部屋の場所を思い出しても、やはり家族の部屋のような気がするけど。そんなことが頭によぎりましたが、それ以上は考えないようにしていました。すると、隣のベッドの中年女性が声をかけてきました。病院だからね、いろいろあるさ。そう言うと少し微笑み、飴を家族と私に一つずつくれたのを覚えています。とてもにこやかで感じのいいおばさんでした。数日後、見舞いに来ていたら遅くなってしまい、面会時間もあと少しという時間になっていました。トイレに行き、家族に声をかけてから帰ろうと部屋へ向かっていた時です。家族がいる部屋のドアが開いたかと思うと、この前見た看護師が出てきました。なぜかとっさに隠れてしまい、様子を見ていると、一緒に出てきたのは家族の隣のベッドのおばさんでした。看護師と手をつないで歩いていきます。すぐに家族のいる部屋に入り、隣のおばさんのことを聞くと、一人でふらっと部屋を出て行ったというので、慌て追いかけました。おばさんと看護師が見え、後ろから、おばさん、おばさんと声をかけるものの、聞こえていないのか全く反応がありません。看護師ももちろん後ろを振り返ることはなく、二人で歩いていきます。エレベーターの前で二人が止まったので走って追いかけ、ちょうどエレベーターに乗ったところでやっと追いつき、エレベーターの中でおばさんの腕をつかむことができました。おばさん大丈夫?そう言うと、看護師はこちらをぎろりと睨み消えていきました。エレベーターには何も覚えていないおばさんと二人だけで乗っており、B2 のボタンが押されていました。
The basement. 後から
知ったのですが、地下2階は霊安室でした。
What?
あの看護師はおばさんを連れていくつもりだったのでしょう。
7の3。Okay, what the fuck did I hear before? Also, I didn't go in here, did I? Okay. Well, I don't see anything. Maybe I should check this. At some point, something is going to show up with this UV light, I'm sure. But not today. I feel like we're going to use this ladder later. Oh, stuff is on the floor. That wasn't on the floor before, was it? This stuff got knocked down? Maybe that's what we heard. Well, I don't see anything. What do you guys think? Should we maybe go? Let's check the map and think about where we've gotten tapes so far. So, we haven't gotten anything at our house. We got the flashlight from the Jidohanki. What's the vending machine place? Then the garbage place, we got a tape. Maybe we should go to the warehouse again. See if anything changed there. Coin for the public phone. Where was that again? It was near those vending machines, right? Okay, I put in the coin. You never look up, do you? I got a tape! What? Oh, is that blood? Oh, that's blood. Oh, it doesn't show up with the UV. Is it going anywhere? Doesn't look like it. Okay, so that's the coin then. So that means we still have the UV light and the rotten food that we need to do something with. I don't like that door being open.
まさきのホラーの話。はい、今回もホラーなお手紙読んでいきますよ。ラジオネームトウコさんからの手紙です。この方おなじみになってきましたね。今回はどのような話なのでしょう。最近知り合った同じバイトの子の話。兄弟が入院し気持ちが下がっている日々、その子は兄弟のためにと毎日病院に通い一生懸命看病していた。あ、すいません、いつもと同じ人ですよね。ああ、やっぱりちゃんと東子さんですね。あ、すみません、いつもと書き方が違うので違う人かと。あ、すいません、はい、続けますね。
Different handwriting.
いつものように病院へ行くと兄弟の担当医が部屋の前に立っていた。別室に案内され、医者の重々しい口が開いた。もう長くはない。もって1ヶ月程度だと。兄弟の病室に行くと、と？あ、すいません。あ、変なところがカタカナになっていて。続きますね。
Oh, the subs are all messed up. 行
くと、兄弟はいつものように笑っていた。それからは時間があるときは少しでも病院に行くようにした。そうするうちに1ヶ月が過ぎ去り、医者に宣告されてから3ヶ月が経とうとしていた。その日はいつもより少し寒かった。病院へ向かう途中、小さな男の子に声をかけられた。お母さん？と。違うよ。そう言うと泣きそうになったため、男の子のお母さんを探すことにした。すぐにお母さんが、みつ？また変なところがカタカナですね。あ、みがカタカナでした。すいません。続けます。
お母さんが
見つかり男の子を渡した。去ろうとする私を見て男の子のお母さんが、疲れているみたいだけど大丈夫ですかと声をかけてきた。家が近いから休んでいってくださいと。自分でも知らないうちに疲れが溜まっていたことに気づき、お言葉に甘えて家に少しだけお邪魔するようにした。お茶とケーキを出してもらい、久しぶりにほっと息をついて休んだ。そんな甘い時間は風のように過ぎ去っていったようだ。時間、大丈夫ですか？と声をかけられ、はっと 時計を見た時には面会時間まであと1時間という時間になっていた。ほんの少しいたつもりがそんなに時間かかっていたのか。ここから病院までは30分かかる。すぐに家を出た。挨拶をきちんとしなかった。そう思い振り返るとそこに家はなかった。しかし気にする暇はない。急いで病院に向かっていると携帯電話が音を立てた。ポケットで小さく鳴った音に私は気づかなかった。病院に着くとドアの前に兄弟に似た小さな男の子が立っていた。不思議に思って近づくと男の子が、
僕が苦しくて痛かった時何してたの？
そんな風に言ったような気がした。慌てて病院に入ったがもう手遅れだった。私は兄弟の名を叫び大声で泣いた。どうして？その瞬間僕が私の中にスーッと入ってきた感覚があった。それから兄弟は私のそばで私をずっと見ている。ずっと。
7の
4。 So okay, so if you canunderstand a little bit of Japanese, it's super confusing because the subtitles don't match the what he's saying at all. But if I think it works if you can't speak Japanese and you're just reading the subtitles. But yeah, in Japanese, every now and then he was like, oh, that's weird. For some reason, this is written in katakana instead of the kanji. So in Japanese, there's like three different styles, basically.That you mix and match to write Japanese. So every now and then a character was written in the wrong style, basically, to put it really simply for anyone who doesn't speak Japanese. And then the narrator would be like, oh, that's weird. They said this particular character in this way. And it was... So for English speaking, they just said coming, I think. So I'm coming. So something is coming for us. But in Japanese, it was...something else, but I didn't catch. I only got like half of it because I was so confused by the subtitles not matching. So which... Oh, the lamp is fixed now. Which lamp broke in here? I don't see anything. These seem fine. Oh. We heard something shatter somewhere. Oh, there's a truck back there. Huh. Can we get there?I don't think so. Oh, actually, a bicycle lock. Well, I have nothing for that, but good to know. Maybe we should go back to our own house?Turn. There we go. Do I just... Oh. Okay, I don't think I can get out anymore here. I think we're just done. Maybe we should go take another look at the warehouse in that case?God, it's so realistic looking. These roads really are like this. Although in Japan, these kind of sections, I was always like, oh my god, thank god, two lanes. I hate those sections where it becomes like one lane and there's like, if you meet a car there, then you're just fucked. One of you is gonna have to back up all the way. I hate those bits. Let's look. I knew it. That's what I was thinking. That they were marked somehow. Oh no. Who the fuck was that? What is this? A voice recorder? So I came from there. There's nothing else here. How do I use it? I don't know. I think I hear a dog. Okay, we didn't get a tape, but we did get a tape recorder. We haven't been to the house in a bit. Maybe we should go check there again. Where we got the key. I don't think we can go in here, though. Do you want some fish? I wonder if there's something else that we can find here. That blood. So we use the UV light now as well. Yeah, I don't see anything I can interact with here. So we have two locks that we don't have a key for. I think I saw tape at the vending machine. We can swing by that. Might as well check. We did get a tape here, though. At the vending machine. Or the phone. Where do you think you saw one? Oh, this tape vending machine. We need a 4-digit number. Well, the UV unfortunately doesn't work. Oh! It does. So 1234 2143 4213? How do we read it? Maybe there's another hint to it? You think it's 4267? Wait, how? 4276. How come? The numpad? Oh, so the fourth button is the first one, then the second button is the second one. That's what you mean. So 4276. Ah. Ah, little smarty pants. Nice. Okay. Good job, guys. I didn't see that. I thought it was just going to be 1, 2, 3, 4. Sports more. Okay. A boar. Can I get out of the car? Should I just go? Okay. Number 5.
まさきのホラーの話。最近このラジオの反響がすごくて嬉しいばかりです。ありがとうございます。ということで今回も読んでいきますよ。はい、今回もおなじみラジオネームトウコさんからです。
は
っ、いつもみたいに誰のお話か今回書いてませんね。まあ読みますね。両親なんて最初からいなかった、そう思っている。弟を私に守らないといけない、それだけだった。私には弟しかいなかった。友人も親戚も誰も私のカタカナですね。
の
前の手紙でも何個かありましたね。読めないことはないんですけど、気にしていると話が止まってしまうので、できる限り気にせず読むようにしますね。続けます。私の周りには誰もいない、いや、いなくなっていた。気づいた時には弟と二人だった。許せなかった、何もかも。私の私の怒りは全てに向いていた。みんな
みんな不幸になればいい、
そう思った。いつも決まった時間に手紙を書いた。丁寧に見えるものすべてを取り込んで、そうした手紙は相手に響く。相手の読んだ時の顔を見るのが好きだった。私たちの世界へごちそうへご、ああ世界へごちそうか。あ、やっぱりカタカナ入ってると読み間違えちゃいますね。まあすいません。続けますね。ごちそうを用意して、弟はいつも私の隣にいる。心配そうな顔をして、そんな弟の手を私は握る。弟が眠ってしまった時、できなかったことを今、苦しみですね。苦しみも悲しみもすべて忘れて、私と共にみんな行こう。私の周りではよく人が亡くなる。私のせいなのだろうか。ほら、 あなたにも会いに行きますよ。下の方に何か書いてありますね。手紙読みましたか？あ、全部カタカナで書いてありますね。手紙読みましたか？ですかね。手紙、でも手紙ってこれのことじゃないですよね。何のことでしょう。手紙、ちょっと、探してみようと思います。あったら、また次回読もうと思います。
Okay. So we had a creepy lady. Maybe there's a tape where she was standing. Although this probably isn't Fatal Frame. She was right here. Yeah, I tried to follow along the Japanese, but he doesn't really point out what is written in katakana all the time. He just has trouble reading it, but he doesn't point out like, oh, the mi is this and this, where the subs are like double L in caps and stuff like that. Tomino no jigoku? Oh, was that it? So Tomino's hell? That's awesome. What should we try next? Oops. It bothers me that our apartment is on the map, but we can't make a stop there. Can't put anything in the mailbox, no. Try the pad with the voice recording. Rats are in the trash area. Let's see. Maybe we can put the fish down somewhere? Oh! Oh! I didn't even know I could open this one. Oh, I got a tape in return! They're eating the fish. Okay. Well, that solved that little predicament. Take a left. The fuck is that? What was that? Some kind of scratching.
ました。鬼川まさきです。前回のラジオを聞いてくださった方はわかると思うんですけど、なんと手紙ありました。資料の間に挟まってて気づきませんでした。ということで今回はこの手紙読んでいきますよ。前回に引き続き今回はどのような話でしょう。今回も毎度おなじみラジオネームトウコさんからのお話です。今回はタイトルのようなものもあるようですね。では早速タイトルから読んでいきましょう。
Oh, you didn't read anything. The tape ends abruptly. What happened after that? He was about to read it. Should be between some documents. I have to find it. Is that light flashing? Who was that? What's going on? Who is that? Is that the lady we saw outside the station? Documents. Oh, here it is. Sticky note on the paper. Read this out loud and you'll know why your brother died. Well then. There was a key. This flashlight is so bright indoors, but outside it's useless. Oh, she did! I didn't even see that. Bicycle lucky. Where'd she go? Trash tongs? Should we go up? Hopefully I don't jump off. Reverse tape. Go down quick. I don't want to be up here. What is that? Oh, that's just for the ladder. Should we go back to the trash place? Now that we have these? Reverse tape, recorder. Oh, we can record the reverse tape and then back, play it back. Should we try that? Can't see. Where'd it go? What? It's gone! How am I gonna listen to it? Shit. Where did it go? Oh, someone moved it. Should we do it? What do I do with it now? The numbers are gone. Yeah, I can't use the tape recorder. Well, I'm gonna go to the trash place first. I couldn't put it in again. It didn't allow me to. So let's have a look. I don't know what these tongs will do though, but maybe we can reach through something? There's a hole. I got it. What is it? Padlock key. Wait, for here? Tape deck. I can use it to reverse tapes. Did I do it? Oh, I reversed it now, I think. I think I can play it now. Oh, exciting! Do you think reading how our brother died would immediately kill us? I feel like that's like an ending you can get. Skirt, skirt! Still cracks me up. I have a tape! All the way. Oh, can't see.
トナコの闇。弟はつくもえ、姉は青銀杏白。トナコには何もできぬ。一人離れゆくトナコ。暗闇には一筋の光も見えぬ。あそこに見えるは怪物か。招こうとも動きはせず、醜い面は面影をも見せず、先には島も色もなき、白きウサギにはついてはいけず、さまようものの骨一つ、変わりゆくのは己か彼か、怪物傍らに置こうとも、鏡に映るは暗き闇、落ちれや落ちやれ落ちずとても、生きゆく先は何もなし。
Masaki must have died because he read this. I don't know what power that poem has, but I need to get it examined. I'll take that paper to the police tomorrow. It's too late, and I should go home for the time being today. That doesn't say anything, right? Because the capitalization is a bit weird. No, I don't think so. Okay, we took the paper. Oh.What a weird poem. Oh! Masaki Onikawa's brother Haruo brought a tape to me. He said, if you listen to this, you will understand the reason for Masaki's death. I decided to listen. However, no matter how much I played it, nothing came out and nothing was recorded on the tape. Haruo panicked. He seemed to be mumbling to himself, it can't be.Suddenly, he handed me a piece of paper. Masaki died because he read this paper aloud. There was a recording on the tape to back it up. After accepting the paper, Haruo whisked away. He had a severe look in his eyes, but... Is he trying to make fun of us, the police? There's no way that a single poem written on paper like this can kill a person. If such a thing were to really happen, it would be a terrible thing. As I was staring at the paper, a younger colleague came over to me.Senpai, what are you looking at? I heard that if you read this poem out loud, you will die. What? Is it superstition or something? Do you really believe in that? The junior laughs. Why don't you try reading it, senior? I was told that, but I couldn't bring myself to read it. Of course, I didn't believe him, but... Are you scared, Senpai? Then I'll read it for you. Laughing, my colleague picked up the piece of paper. Colleague read the whole thing at once.Nothing happened during that time. I didn't expect anything to happen, but I was a little relieved. Nothing happened. Maybe it was just a prank. I was about to say it, or not. He suddenly screamed and collapsed. He never came back. When I noticed, the paper was gone too. What was the poem about? Ending one! I'm sure if we read it, we would have died, right?Huh. So, our brother had a friend who was Toko, right? And Toko sent the letters, but then she was like, you never read my original letter, and then that was the bad one. And then I think that girl that we saw jump was Toko, right? Maybe? Good ending. We did survive, so... kind of good. Hey, Amy. It was good. Not much happened, but I like the environments this time, and I like that you have a car that you just drive around. It made it feel more like an actual place. Like everything was connected. I actually felt like people were living there. I wonder if I continue where it puts me. Like, I really like this level design. A lot of work went into it. It actually feels, like having lived in the countryside in Japan, it feels really, really accurate. But, I mean, Chilla's art has always been really accurate in their level design and settings. But this looks great. I really like it. Let's see. See if I can just not use the tape and read the letter instead.
トナコだよ。弟は熱く燃え、姉は青き息を吐く。トナコには何もできぬ。 一人離れ行くトナコ。暗闇には一筋の光も見えぬ。あそこに見えるは怪物か。招こうとも動きはせず、醜い面は面影も見せぬ。先には島も色もなき、白きウサギにはついてはいけず、さまよう者の骨一つ。変わりゆくのは己か誰か、怪物傍らに置こうとも、鏡に映るは暗き闇。落ちれや落ちあれ落ちずとても、
行き行く先は何もなし。 The room is filling. Am I gonna drown? Oh! What is it? Oh! Oh ho ho ho! Are you gonna jump at me?
I am Onikawa Haruo. Tonako no emi wa zettai yomu na. Yonda ra shinu. Ore ni wa...
Ending 3! Wait, what's ending 2 then? Have you guys heard about the darkness of Tonako? No clue, what is it? Isn't that the if you read it, you're doomed thing? What do you mean by doomed? Someone is singing about the darkness of Tonako. I've heard that you shouldn't read it out loud. But no one knows what the original poem is because the darkness of Tonako has added lines or changed by many people, right? So it's a poem? No, what should I do? I was fooled into reading it out loud. Darkness of Tonako. Little brother burns hot. Oh, there it is. It's the same one again. So people add on to it? That's not funny. If you think you're doing us a favor, well, you're not. What if someone reads it? Rip Lamau. Did you know they found a voice memo that says not read the darkness of Tonako was found? This is my first time hearing about it, and I'm freaking out. I'm gonna read it. Stop it, seriously. It's like a chat room. Just let them do whatever. They're gonna read it anyway. Who's the person who recorded it, and what happened to them? I heard the person read The Darkness of Tonako and recorded it right away because he thought it was dangerous. You shouldn't read it, and if you read it, you're doomed, are basically the same. You should be more specific about what will happen. Aren't they awesome? Respect. Those who read The Darkness of Tonako aloud will die. So it's people just gossiping about the recording. So what's ending two then? If you don't have the voice recorder, you get ending two. Oh, I see. So then we just die and it's a mystery, probably? Rip Lamau. That was funny. I can't skip this. Well, that was pretty good. Yeah, I like those kind of Japanese stories, though, that there's like, if you see this tape or if you read this letter, then you're dead. Like, something's coming for you. I do like that. There seemed to be... I was a little bit confused about how the brother and that lady were connected, really. Or why she came after him. Like, what did he do to her? And why did she become the way she did? We don't really know. But I guess that's the thing with Japanese horror. A lot of times you just don't get the answers. I definitely liked the look of the game the most. It was really fun. And it's always nice to listen to Japanese.